Class 3 English syllabus with worksheets. First topic is sentences with subject and predicate. A sentence is a group of words arranged in the correct order that makes complete sense. And we should remember that a sentence always starts with a capital letter and ends with a full stop. Now some worksheets. First one is tick the groups of words which are sentences. So first one is not a sentence because it not starts with a capital letter and there is no full stop. And second one is Tina is going to the market. It follows all the rules. That means it is a sentence. Now question B, rewrite these groups of words to make meaningful sentences. For the first one, after rearranging, the sentence will be a giraffe has a long neck. And for the second one, it will be a rainbow has 7 colors. Now, subject and predicate. These are new to the kids. The subject of a sentence is the person, animal or thing about whom the sentence is. And the predicate of a sentence tells us something about the subject. It will be more clear with an example. See the example. We will win the match. One more thing to remember that to identify the subject of a sentence, ask the question who or what to the verb and the answer is the subject. Like for this sentence, we will win the match. If we ask a question like who will win the match, the answer is we. So here we is the subject of the sentence. And in a sentence, everything other than the subject is the predicate. So here predicate is will win the match. Now time for some question and answers. First one is Gopal eats 2 bananas every day. Here subject is Gopal and predicate is eats 2 bananas every day. For the second question, subject is Tom and predicate is ran after Jerry. Second topic is nouns including common noun, proper noun, collective noun and material noun. They already learned common noun and proper noun in class 2. Collective noun and material nouns are new for kids. Words that are the names of group of persons, places, animals or things are called collective nouns. Take an example. I have lost the bunch of keys. Here bunch is the collective noun. Some question and answers. First question. Here kids need to choose the correct collective nouns to complete the sentences. First one. You can see a herd of elephants in the forest. And for the second one. The band of musicians played lively music. Words which are the names of materials used for making other things are called material nouns. Like this statue is made of bronze. So here bronze is the material noun. For question E, kids need to circle the material nouns like he put the wood in the fireplace. So here they need to circle wood. Second one, you should always handle glass carefully. So here material noun is glass. Next topic is punctuations and capitalization. Here they will learn the uses of full stop, comma, quotation marks and apostrophes. In this chapter, they will face the questions like rewrite the sentences using necessary punctuation marks. For the first one, they need to start the sentence with capital letter. I should always be capital. Then they need to start with capital letter for New Delhi, Kolkata and Mumbai. They need to put comma between New Delhi and Kolkata. And at last, they need to write full stop. Second example is, ouch, I hurt my foot. For this, they need to start with the capital letter. Then after ouch, they need to write an exclamation mark. I should be capital. And at last, they need to put the full stop. Next topic is pronouns. Here, they will learn some common pronouns. That is, I, we, you, he, she, it, they, them, him, her, me, and us. Next topic is singular and plural. I have already made a video on this topic with worksheets. If you want, you can check that video. I will put the link in the description box. There I have explained all the rules to change singular nouns into plural noun. Now, some nouns form their plurals differently. They do not follow any rule. Those nouns are called irregular plural forms of nouns, like tooth, teeth, mouse, mice, like that. There, kids will also learn countable and uncountable nouns. Now, countable noun means that can be counted and have singular and plural forms. Like we can count cat, table. And uncountable noun means that cannot be counted and do not have the plural forms. Like we cannot count smoke or water, like that. Next topic is gender, including masculine, feminine, neuter and common gender. I have already made a video on gender too. You can watch that video to get the worksheets. I will put the link in the description box. Now, common gender means either a male or a female. Like teacher, baby, they can be a male or a female. Neuter gender means non-living and neither a male or a female. Like book, pencil, table, chair, like that. These are non-living things, neither male nor female. A separate video on articles is also there in the channel. Please do check the description box for the video link. Next topic is adjectives. Adjective means that describe nouns. They tell us about the special qualities of a noun. They also tell us about the color, shape, and size of a noun. Numbers 2 are adjectives. Adjectives can also tell us how much or how many things are there. Now some question and answers. First one, please put some sugar in the bowl. Here adjective is some. Second one, the city of Bengaluru has many gardens. Here adjective is many. Next topic is verbs and tenses. Here they will learn simple tenses like simple present tense, simple past tense and simple future tense. Verb means doing words. So for question 8, kids need to circle dances. For the second one, verb is running. Now the tense of a verb tells us the time when something happens. For simple present tense, it tells us about things which happen in the present time or happen regularly, like we eat rice for dinner. And the sentences that tell us about things which always remain the same are written in the simple present tense, like the earth moves around the sun. Now, simple past tense means actions that happened in the past or before the time of speaking, like we stayed in Mumbai for 5 years. That means it happened in the past. Or suddenly the doorbell rang. There are some ways to change the verb in the past form. We will discuss that in a separate video. Simple future tense means actions that will happen in the future. Like they will act in the play tomorrow. Or I will sleep at 9 o'clock tonight. That means these actions are going to happen in the future. Next is antonyms and synonyms. That means opposites and words with the same meaning. Next topic, prepositions. Prepositions tell us where a person or thing is or where something happens. Some common prepositions are on, in, at, near, with, between, from, and to. In this chapter, they will also learn the uses of under, outside, near, down, over, etc. Next topic is conjunctions. Conjunctions means joining words. And, but, or, and, because are some commonly used conjunctions. Now some question and answers. Here kids need to join these sentences with suitable conjunctions. First one, this house is small, this house is comfortable. Here kids can join these two sentences as this house is small, but comfortable. Next one, walk carefully, you will fall. So they can join this like walk carefully or you will fall. Next topic is interjections. This topic is new for kids. Interjections are words which show surprise and sudden strong feeling. They may show happiness or sadness. We always add an exclamation mark after an interjection. Some commonly used interjections are oh, bravo, hooray, alas, ouch, and wow. There are some more also we will learn in detail on a separate video. Next topic is homophones. Homophones means set of words which sound the same but have different meanings. Like SOM sum means a small amount. SUM sum means a maths problem. Next is DIE die means stop living. And DYE die means substance used to change the color of cloth. Other than these topics, comprehension and paragraph writing is also there in their syllabus. In class 3, they will also learn how to write informal letter. That's all for now. Thanks for watching Kids A to Z.